Which means that we have access to la RSC, to pay RSC frequencies. So at the moment, we are just analyzing the first samples, and I'm going to show you now some particular statistics we found on the universal analysis software. So, for instance, we found out that on MAC35S81, we had out of the 76 samples we were analyzed, 25 were sharing latency within the allele height, and we've seen these characteristics happening also in other population groups, like for instance South Asia or North Africa. We're actually a member of this of the Middle East area. So we found, we think that maybe this can be a characteristic of date having a primary mutation like those in the developed kit. And maybe we can use this information. And I confirm that if we do an analysis with another kit, we have the 5S in the plane, we don't have this problem. So if this sample occurs when we analyze the sample with the policy specifically. Yeah, so as you can see, in a normal CEP, we will have a satisfaction balance of 90%, so 5.2, whereas in the policy, we have 10%. Also, a particular thing we saw that one of the samples on MAP33 had a duplication, and we confirmed this YC, and this is probably a probably just a preservation of this marker into another chromosome. Also on the YSTRs, we found two characteristics that were noted. So one is a duplication on the marker VS41, and I confirm this to CE as well. And we recently published a paper that shows UK and YSTRs population data, and we also found a duplication in this particular marker. But also another marker, which is EYF3871, a duplication in this marker, although this is not present in any other key that were available to us, so I wasn't able to confirm the one of the method. So coming back to our samples, so as I said, we had 72 prevalent samples and 4 missing person samples, and we analyzed them in a database that was created so far just with the database information coming from the forensic version of the DNA. And this being stated together. And we have two possible matches identified. So as shown here, these matches that we may identify, there are 73 degrees of relationships, so they may be uncle, niece, or a grandmother child, or siblings, or a woman to more testings are needed to categorize this better and to raise our to conclude, so our aim is around families, but definitely before being able to do this, we need to have maybe the sequence based information, so the knowing how maybe the allele frequency will change if we introduce sequence based information, maybe this family region information will help, and possibly having more markers.